What's poppin', my peeps? How's it going? Today on the Monday Challenge, we're gonna be messing around with the Insta360 ONE X. Gonna try and edit this footage in Premiere. Let's get it going. If you guys are new to the channel, what's poppin'? My name's Burke Cullen, and I do these weekly filmmaking challenges to try and learn new things and grow as a filmmaker. So if you're into that sort of thing, hit the old subscribe guy button down there.
Just opened this up, just charged it. Still have all the boxes and stuff everywhere.
So we got this because a client of ours wants to do like 360 video and photo. So I'm gonna, you know, test it out today and see if I can edit it in Premiere. Apparently the files from this, you can't open them in Premiere. So apparently there's a workaround. So we ordered the selfie stick, but it didn't come in yet for some reason. So I'm just gonna use this GorillaPod for the time being, just so I can film this video. I figured I'll just go rip around the park with this dude, get some footage, and where are you going? I'm just gonna do like a little sequence, kind of like a vlog style thing, but yeah, see you guys in a bit. So I just went out, got some footage. I'm actually really excited just looking at it on my phone. I'm really excited on how this came out, and I can't wait to start editing this together. One thing I will say is I actually didn't use this. I used a magic arm instead because I noticed that the Joby was getting into the shot. Magic arm was still in the shot, but it's not as big, so it wasn't as distracting as the Joby was. I'm actually using the magic arm right now for the monitor onto the camera, so I'll leave a link down in the description below for you guys to check out what a magic arm is if you don't know what it is. Just a great accessory to have for filmmaking. So I have to download two apps. I gotta download the Insta360 editor, and then apparently, if you export the footage from Insta360, the editor that they provide you with, you can bring that into Premiere and then download the GoPro VR plugin for Premiere and then edit the footage that way. Let's open up the GoPro one first. Oh, look, it has it for After Effects and Premiere. That's cool. All right, now let's download Insta360 Studio. Whoa! There's a Premiere plugin. There is a Premiere plugin for this thing. So here's the deal. Initially, when this came out, you couldn't edit the footage in Premiere. Maybe you can now. Maybe this isn't much of a challenge at all. I mean, hey, last week was a bit of an extreme one. If you guys didn't see that, by the way, you should check it out. Link in description. 24-hour music video edit. Shoot and edit. Now, how do I, All right, there's the Insta360 Studio. I don't know, it doesn't look like it did a Premiere plugin. It says Premiere plugin. Compatible with ONE X. Maybe I can just bring in the, if I just bring in the footage, maybe it will work. Let me try that. I will be stoked if I don't have to do that batch export thing that I read about earlier. Oh! I'm just gonna bring one down on the timeline and see what happens. I just thought this was gonna be really easy and got really stoked.
A few inches later.
I can't open either plugin in Premiere. And the only one that I thought I was gonna be able to get to work was the GoPro one, so I need to figure that one out in order to edit this footage properly. So after a little bit of frustration, I caved, I Googled it, and apparently the plugin that I had wasn't for Adobe Premiere Pro 2019, it was for 2018. So I did find this article thingamabob here on GoPro that says that there is a updated GoPro VR plugins for Premiere Pro CC 2019 and After Effects 2019. So I'm gonna download that. And hopefully this works. Hey, there it is. It works. If you are using Adobe Premiere Pro and you do have the Insta360 and you want to know how to edit it in Premiere Pro, there is a workaround. Just use the GoPro thing. And apparently you can bring the footage into Adobe Premiere Pro. I would probably recommend downloading the editing software anyways, because I think maybe that gave me the ability to open it up in Premiere. But as far as being able to reframe it and edit it, I got that GoPro app. I'll put that in the description below. All right, I'm gonna piece this thing together, we'll watch it, and then we'll do a little recap.
Yeah.
aside from trying to figure out how to actually edit the stuff in Premiere, this was more of a fun challenge than anything. And then as far as creating the tiny world, these are kind of the same settings that I used every time. I did have a few minor adjustments with the yaw, the pitch, and the roll. Once I was able to kind of dial those in, I kind of just copied and pasted those onto any clip that I wanted to create that tiny world effect. If you guys are new here, I do have a playlist for a bunch of other Monday challenge videos if you'd like to check them out. It's at the end screen in this video. I'll also leave a link down in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. If you guys have any questions in regards to anything, please let me know in the comments below. Like the video, subscribe, ring the bell, all the things that you do. And as always, stay hungry.